You focus on cakes. Cakes is an excellent business. Find out why the business is less. That's the first thing. I don't know when did you start this business, but if business was good initially, now the business is less, then we need to find out the reasons. Either there is some issue with the quality or there's some issue with the delivery part. What exactly is hampering you? Or are you not able to market yourself properly? You have to find out the reason. Once you know the reason, once the questions are clear, the answers will also be clear. But if you are doing cake and cake is not doing good, and if you think by adding sandwich, pasta, pizza, burgers, you will be able to improve sales, I don't think so. Because when you are doing cakes, I think people know you as a cake specialist. When you are doing cake, sandwich, pasta, pizza, burgers, people know that you are a generalist. You are selling all chalu items, all fast food items, and then you get no branding, no identity. You don't have a specialty. And in this age, especially from home business, if you don't have a specialty, it is very difficult to sell. My suggestion is focus on cake. Find out why it is not happening. What is the problem with cake? Diversify within cake. You know, if you are doing, let's say, birthday cakes, you start doing small pieces, pastries, you start doing cupcakes. So there is many things you can do within cake, but don't go outside this, because if bakery is your specialty, you stay within that. That's my suggestion, of course. AK Singh, restaurant staff. Frankly speaking, sir, I don't have an answer. I have a staff and they are having food as they wish. I can't even question them. They can eat whatever they want. I cannot ask a single question. The moment I ask, I start asking too much questions, they will start leaving it. And if they run away, I am in a bigger problem. Typically, what we do is we hire a separate room, we hire a separate kitchen for them. Because if there is a separate staff kitchen, they will have chawal dal, you know, atta, oil. You give them all essentials, give them some monthly allowance for vegetables, and that's it. Your liability is over. But if you are running an Italian restaurant and you have staff within the restaurant where they are, you know, cooking food on the same kitchen, probably who will stop them from having roti with Alfredo sauce? And it will hit you badly. So it happens, it had happened with us. So right now, our arrangement is we put staff in a separate kitchen. The kitchen is separate. Their living area is completely different. It is in an area where the rentals are less, where there is nearby vegetable market so that they can go and have vegetables. There is a monthly allowance which is fixed. Whether the vegetables are 20 rupees kg or 100 rupees kg, at least I'm not bothered. Their monthly allowance is fixed. So my headache is done. Now it is up to them what they want to cook. I don't care. You know, they want to have chicken every day in the month. Let them have it. My liability is fixed. My exposure is limited. This is how we handle, but we are different. Other cities are different. Your staff is different. I don't know what will work on them. In fact, this is one area within this entire industry where nobody has a clear-cut rule that how do you deal with staff? How do you retain staff? How do you prevent them from running away? I have discussed with so many people. I have traveled to so many cities, but till date, I don't have a clear answer. I don't have a clear answer. Employee meals per month, very difficult. You know, it depends on city. The city where we are in, we typically spend 1,000 rupees per month per employee, around that, you know. So 1,000 to 1,200 is the per month thing. But if you are doing an arrangement of tiffin, then your expenses are much more, because tiffin will be minimum 45-50 rupees per tiffin. So in a day, if you give them two tiffins, it is 100 bucks, and in monthly it is 3,000 bucks. Better than giving them tiffin is give them gas stove, give them the raw materials, and ask them to cook. That's the best thing you can do. Because tiffin, you will have complaints that one tiffin is not enough, I remain hungry. You know, that taste is not good, you change it. If there is some issue with the tiffin guy, you get into unnecessary trouble. So avoid that. Give them raw materials, give them cooking utensils, give them gas stove, give them a monthly allowance that this is your allowance for vegetable, you manage within this figure. That's what we do, and I think this works pretty well. Last 2 years we didn't have an issue, but depends city to city and how your competitors are treating them. If their competitors are giving them a royal treatment, then you have no option but to extend the same. Rahul is saying, but I don't get to the skill and decoration. So you think if decoration is an issue, if cake designing or if, you know, being a cake artist is what you aspire to be, then that's not a very difficult skill to learn. I think if you want to make it a business, either you learn cake decoration or you diversify to cupcakes. Cake art is a little more intricate to manage. Cupcakes are small and you just need some basic things to decorate cupcakes. Easy to handle. You can sell them in boxes, you know, 2 cupcake box, 6 cupcake box, 12 cupcake box, 50, 60 rupees, people don't mind spending. You know, cupcakes can be from 40, 50 rupees to 100, 120 rupees, depending upon what variation you're using. And when you look at profitability, food cost and margins per unit, I think cupcakes makes a better business sense. Because birthday cake, no matter how, you know, good you are, even if you are doing a fondant cake, a complete artistic fondant cake will be 1,000, 1,100 rupees a kg. But then you have to be really good in fondant art in order to get it done. If you're not into fondant, if you're more into buttercream and if you're more into icing, then your hands must be skilled to do that. With 1/10 of that skill, you can decorate cupcakes and get to the similar business. So if skill is the problem, if decoration is the problem, my suggestion is move back into cupcakes, vanilla cupcakes, blueberry cupcakes, chocolate lava cakes. Get into that business. Learn to decorate them well. Start spreading your audience. I think that is one viable business line for you. But again, a warning sign. If you diversify into everything, you'll go nowhere. Srujan, my restaurant is in Ulhasnagar. Ulhasnagar, yes, I understand. Expected sale was around 5K. Happening place. Okay. So are you into dal pakwan or those, you know, Sindhi speciality kind of stuff, Srujan? Or are you waiting for the markets to open? No. Don't do this. Don't hire a Sindhi guy and think that he will manage guests and, you know, he will do the PR on your behalf and you will start attracting Sindhi crowd. No, never. This doesn't happen. After 3 months, you will find the same guy which you have hired for public relation. He will become your competitor. You are dealing with Sindhi community, one of the most shrewd business community in India. No disrespect to them. I have full faith and full regard to them. I'm just telling you, that's how they understand business. If the guy understands that the business is excellent and just by his PR skills, you are getting this 5,000 business per day, he will start thinking that, why do I work for this guy? Why don't I open my own thing? What do I don't know? You know, I can also make Sindhi dishes, veg, non-veg, whatever it is. I can make those Sindhi dishes. I can run with it. He will become your competitor. And don't think that unless you talk in a Sindhi, you know, tone, or unless you are a Sindhi, you can't get Sindhi business. No, I'm not a Gujarati. I'm doing business in Gujarat. I do business in almost every city of Gujarat. I can't even speak Gujarati properly. I can understand Gujarati, I can't speak. And I have a strong feeling that, you know, there is a discrimination between locals and outsiders. It happens in every city, in every country of the world. So nothing is immune to that. But that doesn't mean that I hire a Gujarati just to do liaison with the local people. No. In business, the language of money, everybody understands without any question. You are in Ulhasnagar, man. Don't worry about that. Had you been in, you know, let's say southern part of Gujarat or Saurashtra, it would have been a different question. But you are in Ulhasnagar. Don't worry about it. Wait for the markets to open. You will do just fine. Have faith in yourself. If your food is good, you will do good business. This community, whether it is Sindhi community, Parsi community, Guju community, they appreciate your quality very much. If they know that your food quality is decent, you are offering genuine quality, you will get business whether you are Sindhi or not. Don't worry about it. AK is saying exactly what happens. Yeah. This is brownies. Yes, brownies could be fine. Cloud kitchen is an excellent idea. But then, yes, you are right. Stick to your course, you know, speciality. 6 to 8 items are enough. And I have mentioned in one of the videos in bootcamp also, I'm telling it again now. What is your goal when you start food business? Your goal is to hit that 10,000 per day mark. That is your goal. If that 10,000 per day mark is done by 3-4 items, why do you want to create a 10-page menu? There is no need. If you have only 4-5 items in the menu and your, you know, items are strong enough, because that helps you in gaining expertise also, that helps you in defining your USP, that helps you in defining your superstar dish. Remember, I talked about it. Have this. So even if, you know, even if you're starting a cloud kitchen from home, those things are important. You define your business, you define your USP, you define your superstar dish. As long as you follow those steps, you'll do just fine. Whether there are 5 items in the menu or 50, doesn't matter. Sakit, no, my suggestion is to start with one. Start with one. So that you know how does it become profitable on a standalone basis. Let me tell you one fact. If you can make one outlet profitable, you can handle 10 outlets. But if you start with 3 outlets or if you start with 2 outlets, chances of your success just reduces by half. Because managing one outlet has its own challenges. You have to look at food quality. You have to look at, you know, customer relation. You have to look at traffic. You have to look at responsiveness, delivery, everything. You are already doing this. Now there is a second outlet. Now there has to be, you know, material movement from one outlet to second and vice versa. There will be staff movement. There will be, you know, different emergencies at different outlets. Why do you want to complicate your life by launching 2 outlets in once? If you are so confident on your abilities, launch the first outlet, make it a, you know, good outlet within 3 months. If your food is good, if your business skills are good, you can be profitable from the first month itself. Wait for 3 months, wait for 100 days precisely to make it sustainable, to make it standalone profitable, then start second outlet if you are so confident. But don't take, you know, disproportionate risk by starting 3 outlets at once. My suggestion always is 1 outlet. Whether it is McDonald's, whether it is Chipotle Grill, whether it is Subway, whether it is Tudova Eats, everything started from 1 outlet, and you should also start from 1 outlet. Very simple.